Hey guys, in this new video, we're going to continue with our discussion of Lewis acids and bases. So if we take a look at this example, it says, identify each of the following compounds in the following chemical equation. So here we have to identify who is a Lewis acid and who is a Lewis base. So remember, a Lewis acid has less than 8 electrons around it, or it's partially positive. It can accept more electrons to fulfill its octet rule. We're going to say that the Lewis base is when a central element has lone pairs, or when the compound in general has a negative charge. If we take a look here, we have these two compounds somehow merging together to give us this one product here. What we're gonna say here is we have aluminum, which is a group 3A element. It has 3 valence electrons that it's using to make those bonds. So we know it doesn't have a lone pair. And we should also realize here that it is sharing an electron from each one of the bromines. So in total, aluminum has 6 electrons around it. It's not fulfilling its octet rule, so it has space to accept more electrons to get to 8. So we're going to say that this compound here is the Lewis acid, which would mean that the other compound would be our Lewis base. But why? Just realize, remember, oxygen is in group 6A, so it has 6 valence electrons. It's using 2 of them to make those bonds, which means it has 2 lone pairs that we don't see. So what it does here is it uses its lone pair and shoots them out and shares them with the aluminum. Now remember, Lewis is different than Bronston-Lowry. In Bronston-Lowry, we're donating a proton. We stay behind. We throw the proton over to the other compound, and we stay behind as a new compound. But here, we're sharing electrons, not protons. If I'm sharing my electrons with you, I'm going to come along for the ride. So this whole compound is going to share its electrons with the aluminum, but the whole compound comes along with it. So that's why we get one massive product at the end. And because I'm adding them together, we call this an adduct. Because again, I'm adding them together. So the name shows us the relationship that's going on. Lewis acid, Lewis base combined together to give me one product. An addition of 2 things, an adduct. Now that you've seen that, try to use your reasoning skills to attempt to do the practice questions below. Again, if you get stuck, don't worry, come back, watch a video of me explaining which compound is which.